love skillful, and we're gonna be discussing about opportunity seeking market product fit. So, what is opportunity seeking? Opportunity seeking is a process of spotting, evaluating, and pursuing relevant and sustainable revenue and profit generating activities in the marketplace. So, in other words, ang opportunity seeking is mahalaga siyang process sa business kasi dito mo makikita yung mga possibilities na pwede sa business mo, ganun, kung ano yung pwede mong gawin para mas mapalago pa siya. And kung paano yung step-by-step process, kung paano yung pag-generate ng profit mo and revenue.
Pain point process. There are four steps in this process, which are step 1, pain hunting, step 2, pain points identification, step 3, pain points understanding, and step 4, pain points healing. Let us now proceed on the first step of the pain point process. Pain hunting. In this process, the entrepreneurs must choose a specific group of people as their target market, customer or non-customer. The entrepreneur must also make sure that their company is capable of serving the group well. Under the pain hunting, there are four types of consumer benefits. First is the functional benefit. This benefit is related to the performance of the product or service. For example, Man's Meat and Filters Incorporated has proprietary training on the 5 skills of master strategists. The second one is the economic benefit. This benefit is related to the price of the product or service. For example, Ever Milena cosmetics are good quality but cheaper than imported cosmetics. The third one is the emotional benefit. This benefit is related to how the owner feels when owning or using the product or service. For example, I feel like I have a high self-worth when I hold a cup of Starbucks coffee. And the last one is the social benefit, which is the benefit that is related to how others will perceive the owner of the product or service. For example, seeing entrepreneurs riding in their BMW, Volvo, or Benz makes me think they are successful.
The first one is the functional benefit, and it is the benefit related to the performance of the product or service. The second one is the economic benefit. It is the benefit related to the price of the product or service. The third one is the emotional benefit. It is the benefit related to how the owner feels when owning or using the product or service. And the last one is the social benefit. It is the benefit related to how others will perceive the owner of the product or service.
The second step is the pain points identification. So what are the pain points? Pain points are a combination of a consumer's dislikes as well as his or her wishes. After the dislikes are stated, the wish list can be asked to ensure no area of dissatisfaction is left effects during a purchase, which is being sold. The display unit with some scratches need to fall and then you pay twice for furniture at the furniture cashier and for appliances at the appliances cashier, and long time to process payment. The sex after purchase. Delivery schedule should not be anytime within morning or within afternoon, but have a narrower reach for shorter waiting time. And guard inspects product bought. Wishlist during a purchase. Something interesting to read or watch while waiting for payment processing. Wishlist after purchase. Coordinate and briefing about installation. Example, extra parts to be bought, different crew to be expected for installation. Another example of pain points. If the suppliers are unable to be relevant, the retail channel members. First is lack of area coverage. Second, unsupervised placement and merchandising. Third is sporadic availability of stocks. Fourth is low margin. Fifth, transactional approach, not relational or strategic in account development. And unprofessional salespeople. Third step in the pain point process is the pain points understanding. In this step, explains that not all pain points have the same level of importance. The entrepreneur must understand the frequency and depth of the pain point and then choose the key pain point priorities that must be solved. For example, Dragon Edge's founders Dennis and Emily Balatiha visited Boracay in 2005. They loved Boracay so much they wanted to put up a business in order to keep returning. Scouting for a beachfront location for a franchise burger business, they noticed people were using some dock that were clinical, lifeless, and traditional, and decided to launch a fun, innovative, and youthful Beach Hut Sundog Summer next year. The fourth step in the pain point process is the pain healing. It says here that it is important for entrepreneurs to have empathy and not just understand pain points but also accept that change is needed in their product or in their company. They also must have a regular schedule to go on field visits and converse with customers and consumers daily, so that they would know what to improve in their products and also in their service. Pain healing examples. Melissa Yung-Yap was doing anthropological studies in indigenous communities but was always asked for help in improving the livelihood of these groups. So she took courses on entrepreneurship instead and created God Heart Foundation in 2007, which is dedicated to the greater purpose of helping develop grassroots enterprises. The foundation has given birth to social enterprises that acted as a bridge to help the marginalized get out of poverty by giving them more opportunities. These social enterprises include God Heart Community Shop, Earth Kitchen, God Heart Gallery, God Heart Rowing Lab, among others. Sometimes the owners themselves experience pain points, and from that they knew and understood the need of the consumers immediately. First is the story of Abenson. Abenson founder Wilson Lim could not get the retail space he wanted in some of the major malls, so then
example of how people live lifestyle trend. Fruta's founder Lester Yu saw how people's lifestyle was changing. They were becoming more health conscious, but fresh fruit juice was available only in high-end locations, and there was a large unserved mass market. Because of this, he decided to open his first fresh juice store in SM Manila in 2002. Frutas became a threat to the mass consumers since it is healthy, delicious, and fresh. Next, for the how people work lifestyle trend, Darlene T created the colorful Belle du Jour Power Blender in November 2006 as a new category of paper-based planner to help women manage their careers and their lives. Darlene found that young women were still using manual planners despite mobile appointment tools because they were more tactile, meaningful, and real to them. For the how people play lifestyle trends, Cebu-based Islands Finnair founder Jay Aldriger knew that shirts were the preferred souvenir items from his various travels since they were light and practical. But he saw the pain point of substandard quality shirts being sold in Baguio and Boracay. Hence, he resolved to introduce something fresh in 1992 to professionalize a predominantly cottage type industry. For the how people die lifestyle trend, many donate relief goods, yet the wrong products are often given. For instance, canned goods are given but there are no can openers that go with them. Mega Sardines launched pull-up tub cans to solve this pain point. Despite the slight premium price compared to the regular cans, consumers have responded and the market ranking of Mega has leapfrogged since then. How people invest lifestyle trend. Spectrum Investments was set up because its founder Carl D, a former top-notch sales director of a leading real estate company, saw some property buyers having unpleasant experiences with their property purchase. Spectrum offered to educate property buyers via a 360-degree advice, not just provide positive sales points, but also the cons and challenges from start to finish as well. What is voice of enterprise? It is a process to articulate the needs of the entrepreneur of or his or her company.
Market-driven strategy or market-driving strategy. While there are many opportunities in the marketplace, entrepreneurs must look at whether they want to serve customers or non-customers, and note that the latter may be a bigger market, especially if market penetration level is low. Basically, what you want to do about non-customers. A market-driven strategy is the long-term planning of a business to provide the maximum value or advantages to the customers. The main target of the market-driven strategy is to provide maximum value to the customers. The market-driving strategies are strategies that embrace innovative changes in the logic of industry and business system to grow its profit in industry's demand from undeserved and unserved markets. An example of this could be from the company Omron, who manufactures control equipment, medical equipment, etc. Sold millions of units of electronic blood pressure monitors at a premium price versus the stethoscope and traditional blood pressure machine. There was a bigger market for housewives who were non-customers compared to the
One of the interesting opportunity is targeting the bottom of the pyramid, or POP, or people classified as poor, to create inclusive growth, giving prosperity to as many people as possible. One example of this is the Solid 88 Taxi in Davao, kung saan yung mga regular drivers na meron silang free rent kapag Sunday para magkaroon sila ng extra income para sa pamilya nila. Tapos in case man na yung revenue na makuha nila hindi enough, bibigyan sila ng credit line tapos pwede nilang bayaran na lang on the other day. Practical ways to spot business opportunities based on growth strategy. Growth strategy has 5 parts: segment opportunity, product opportunity, channel opportunity, geography opportunity, and business model opportunity. First, an example of segment opportunity is Hortaleza Professional is one of the biggest brands of HBC. It started its business plan in the salon market segment by offering nail polish and cuticle remover, and expanded to hair coloring, becoming the leading hair coloring brand by volume in the Philippines. The second one is product opportunity. Raulito Bralo, the exclusive master license of Bomanite in the Philippines, did not really plan to get a franchise of Bomanite. He just chanced upon Bomanite while vacationing in Las Vegas with his wife in 1990. He was fascinated to see how regular concrete was transformed to look like natural stones and bricks. He had the foresight that this product will be a hit in the country, realizing that soon the supply of natural stones and pebbles will be limited. Even when natural stones and pebbles was just booming in the 80s. Without the benefit of Google or internet searches, he went out and looked for the supplier in the yellow pages. Unfortunately, the company just transferred their headquarters and the one listed in the category was outdated. It took Raleigh's determination and creativity to find where the new head office was, and eventually bagging the exclusive rights to Bomanite's proprietary stamp concrete system in the Philippines. The third one is channel opportunity. Kim Lato started Kim Store in 2006 when she was still a sophomore at the De La Salle University. Her favorite hobbies were photography and browsing the internet. While browsing for reviews of a particular camera lens, Kim realized there was no online equivalent in the Philippines. Her Kim Store can be the Philippine equivalent of Amazon for consumer electronics, so Filipinos need not purchase from abroad. She started selling cameras with her online platform, but expanded to mobile phones, which eventually gained a huge share of the consumer purchase. Today, Kim Store is one of the fastest growing e-commerce stores in the Philippines. Geography opportunity. The example of this is the partners of 22 Toucher, a 2-in-1 barbershop and Third Wave coffee bar, decided to create a premium price, premium service chill place for men because of the opportunity created by the location along the streetscape community mall, which is a stone throw away from Maria Luisa Village, Cebu Forbes Park, along Paseo Saturnino. Next is business opportunity. Newspapers and magazines used to be bought on the street or subscribed to via newspaper boy or direct from the publisher. Today, newspaper like Inquirer's Libre and magazine like Northern Living and Southern Living are change in the business model. A final lesson about opportunity is to understand there are always costs to pursue an opportunity. Costs related to losing when a film does take badly, direct costs, and costs related to losing when a film does nothing, opportunity costs, and gets left behind in the industry must be avoided.
Voice of Customers, or VOC, is a research process used to capture the changing needs of consumers to provide with the best as our product quality. It is used to identify the quality attributes needed for a supplies component or material to incorporate in the process or product. Voice of Customer can be captured using the following: direct discussions or interviews, surveys, focus groups, customer specifications, observations, warranty data, field reports, complaint logs, and etc. Merger and acquisition, according to Investopedia, is the consolidation of companies or assets through various types of financial transactions, such as mergers, acquisitions, consolidations, tender offers, purchase of assets, and management acquisitions. A merger occurs when two separate entities, usually of comparable size, combine forces to create a new joint organization in which, theoretically, both are equal partners. For example, both Daimler-Benz and Chrysler ceased to exist when the two firms merged, and a new company, Daimler-Chrysler, was created. An acquisition refers to the purchase of one entity by another entity, usually a smaller firm by a larger firm. A new company does not emerge from an acquisition. Rather, the acquired company or target firm is often consumed and ceases to exist, and its assets become part of the acquiring company. Legally speaking, a merger requires two companies to consolidate into a new entity with a new ownership and management structure, ostensibly with members of each firm. An acquisition takes place when one company takes all or all of the operational management decisions of another. The more a common interpretive distinction rests on whether the transaction is friendly, merger, or hostile acquisition. Diversification, according to Entrepreneur.com, is a risk reduction strategy that involves adding products, services, location, customers, and markets to your company's portfolio. The rationale behind this technique contends that a portfolio constructed of different kinds of investments will, on average, yield higher returns and pose a lower risk than an individual investment found within the portfolio. For example, an auto company may diversify by adding a new car model or by expanding into a related market with trucks. Another strategy is called conglomerate diversification. This happens when a company decided to expand into industries that are unrelated to its current business. For example, a car company may decide to enter the computer business, the toothpaste business, the real estate business, and the furniture business.
For a new business, an entrepreneur generates a profit with a new product or service. For expansion, it entails by opening up new stores in different physical locations while still maintaining the current